Hi, I'm Helle. Today we'll take a look at Diceforge, how the game is set up and played, and at the end of the video I will come with my impression of the game. The game is for 2 to 4 players, it takes about 45 minutes to play and is for the ages 10+. Let's take a look at how to play the game. And here we have a full setup of the game. Let's take a look at how to set the game up. Each player will receive a player board with 5 cubes. You will place all the cubes at level 0 for the victory points, for the blue area, which is the moon, and for the red area, which is the sun. The gold is depending on each player's order in the player count, how much gold they will start with. We will take a look at that in a moment. Each player will get 2 dice, 1 darker die with 2 victory points and 1 with the value 1 in blue. And then there will be 4 gold coins with the value of 1. And on the other die we have a red value 1 and 5 gold with a value of 1. The youngest player will get the start player marker and will start with 3 gold. Second player will start with 2 gold, the third player with 1 gold and the fourth player with 0 gold. If you're playing with 3 players, then you will also get 3 gold for the first player, 2 for the second and 1 for the third player. If you're playing with 2 players, then the start player will start with 3 gold coins and the second player will start with 2 gold coins. At the center of the table we will place this temple, and here we have all the dice faces, and we have 10 die pools with different tokens that can be bought for gold. If you're playing with 3 or 4 players, you will use all the die faces. If you're only playing with 2 players, then from each die pool, you will randomly remove 2 of the die faces. At the center of the table, we will place this island, and each player will place their pawn of their matching color at the matching space at the center of the table. And we will take the round marker and place it on number 1. If there are 2 or 4 players, the game will be played over 9 rounds. If there are 3 players, the game will be played over 10 rounds. For this setup, we have chosen all the recommended cards for your first gameplay. And on each card, there is a value at the lower button on the left or the right, and it matches the number where it should be placed. And the graphic on the card, the art on the card, also matches where it is supposed to be placed. If you're playing with 4 players, you will use all the cards. If you're playing with 3 players, then remove 1 card. If you're playing with 2 players, then you will remove 2 cards from each deck of cards. For your first gameplay, you will need these hammer tokens. This card will use these hammer tokens. We will need these, which can give you more space, more room on your board. And these will belong to this card. These tokens will be used if a player ever gets over 100 points, then you will put it here and reset your scoring. Now let's take a look at the rules for the game. The game is played over a number of rounds. 9 rounds if you are 2 to 4 players, 10 rounds if you are 3 players. And in each round, each player will get their turn. And a turn consists of 4 steps. The first step is all players will receive a divine blessings. The second step is the active player may call for reinforcements. And the third step is the active player may perform an action. And the fourth step is the active player may perform an extra action. At the first step, all players will receive a divine blessings. This means that all players, they will roll their 2 dice and get the values that their die shows. So this can be done simultaneously by all the players. These players will receive 2 gold, 2 gold, 2 gold, and this player will receive 1 red and 1 gold. 2-player game, then each player will roll their dice twice in the first phase. So they will receive the divine blessing 2 times. And then it's only the active player's turn. At step number 2, after you have received your divine blessings, then you may use any reinforcement cards you have. These cards you can acquire during the game that has this symbol on them. You will lay them in a stack where you can see this ability that you will receive. On this card, you can choose either a gold, a red, or a blue. And this player might want to choose a blue. And with this reinforcement card, the player can give up 3 gold and then receive 4 glory points. You may only use each ability on the card once per turn, and it's only when you are the active player in step number 2 that you may use these abilities. And the third step, the active player may perform an action. There are 2 actions you can choose. Either you can choose A, make an offering to the gods, or you can choose B, perform a heroic feat. If the player chooses to make an offering to the god, you will go to the temple. And at the temple, you can purchase new sides, new die faces for your die. And you can buy 1 or more die faces, but you may never buy more than 1 from each dice pool. There are 10 different die pools, and you may only purchase from 1 of them on each turn. So this player could choose to buy, he has 7 coins, so he might buy this one where you will receive 6 gold, or you could take this one. If there is a plus sign, then it means you will get both. You will get a blue and 2 gold. And on this one, if there is a question mark, then you have to choose which one of the sides you would want to use. So here I would have to choose 1 gold or 1 red or 1 blue. So he might go for this one. This would cost 4. 1, 2, 3, 4. And then he might go for this red one for 3. You don't have to spend all your gold. And then the player would have to choose to place this on his die, which has to swap out a space. And you can just put it under here and press it up and remove one side and put a new side to the die. When you have placed one, you may not rearrange the order or where you have placed these sides to the die, these die faces. So you have to choose carefully on which die you want to place them. You can place them both on the same or on either one. But this player now has 2 stronger dies, and you will get more of these die faces. So in this action, you may purchase die faces, and you may purchase more than 1, but you may not purchase from the same dice pool, only 1 per dice pool. When we choose the action, perform a heroic feat, then we can buy a card, we can purchase a card. And here you can spend your red or your blue, the sun or the moon, to buy cards. You can use your blue moon elements to buy cards from this section, and you can use the red to buy down here. And you may only buy 1 card. So the blue player, he could choose to spend up to 2 of the red or 2 of the blue. So I think the blue player here, he might want to purchase this card. There's already a player here, so if he wants to buy this card, then he can use 2 of his blue. This card has a cost of 2, and he will bump away the orange player back to the center of the island. This player will now receive a divine blessing. So the player, the orange player, will roll their dice and get the values of their dice they will show. So it's a good thing for a player to be bumped by another player. And the blue player can now purchase this card. Some of them they have a symbol here, and some of them they don't. These with a symbol is a card you can use at the second step. So if you have this card when you are at the second step, then you can use this ability. And when you purchase the card, you will turn it around and lay it near your board. If you get more of these cards, for example, if you get this card here, you will lay it down here. So you can always see what different reinforcements you have. And this ability can be used on your next turn, and only when you are the active player. This ability means that you may choose 1 of your dice and roll it and get whatever it shows. So it's a good way to get more values on your board. So when you get a heroic feat, you will spend either the blue or the red values, or maybe both, and purchase 1 card. And you will always put your meeple where you are purchasing a card And if there is a meeple, then you will bump it back to the center and they will receive a divine blessing. Some of the cards, they have this instance, kind of like lightning. So you will get this one time. It's a one-time use. And on this card, you will receive this hammer token and you will turn this card around and place it up here on your board. You have a space for it here. And you will put this hammer token has a one and a two side, and you will start on the one side and place it here. Whenever you receive gold, if for example I received 7 gold, then I could move this up 7 on this track instead of using this track. I could also divide it, so I would take maybe 3 here and 4 here. If you get up to this location, then you will receive 10 points the first time, and the second time you would receive 15 victory points. You can only use this card 2 times, and it doesn't give any victory points. So you have to fulfill these tasks to be able to gain victory points with this card. If you purchase this card, then you will receive this one, where you can have more room for the gold and for the red and the blue, and you will place it at the end of your player board. So you now can have up to 16 coins, and you can have 9 of the red and 9 of the blue. When you receive a divine blessing, if, for example, I would receive a divine blessing where I would receive gold now, and there aren't any space, then they are just lost. So it's a waste. But it's a good thing you can purchase this one, then I would be able to move up here. And this card means that all other players, they will roll both of their dice, and you may pick 2 of the die faces and use them. And this one is victory point, and this one you will be able to get another face for your die. And when you use this one, you will put this on your die, and then if you, for example, would get this one, then you would receive 3 red. Here you would receive 3 gold. You will multiply with the other die's result, and that is what you will receive. With this card, then you may roll both of your dice 2 times and get the values they show. And this card will earn you 26 victory points. And with this card, you will earn 10 points, and you may choose one of your die and roll it 4 times and get the values it shows. And with this one, you can purchase a new die face. And with this one, if this comes up, then you may choose another player's die face. You may copy another player's die face. And this one is 14 points, and this one is 8 points, and all other players, they have to roll both of their dice and go down what values they show. So if a player would have shown this, then they would have to go backwards. So it's one that is, you don't gain anything, but all others, they will lose something when you choose this card. And you will of course receive 8 points. With this card, this is a card you can keep, and in step 2, you may choose either a gold or a red or a blue value. So you will turn it like this and you will have this ability. And with this card, you would receive 2 points at the end of the game, and then you would receive 3 gold and 3 of the blue, and you will only receive it once. And all the values on the cards, you will not go up on the board when you receive cards. They will be counted for at the end of the game. And here you may, for 3 gold, gain 4 victory points. And you can all these cards with this symbol, you can only use them once per turn, and only when you are the active player. In the game, it's allowed for you to own more of the same cards. But you can only buy 1 card when you choose this action. As step number 4, the active player may perform an extra action. You can spend 2 of your red, and if you do so, then you may take 1 more action. And the action can be either make an offering to the god and buy a dice face, or it can be perform a heroic feat. So you can take the action phase 1 more time. And that is the 4 steps in the game. When all players have had their turn, then we will move the round marker 1 space ahead, And the start player will be the same player for the whole game. The start player will now start the next round of the game. And when we ever get to the ninth round, if we are two or four players, then all players, they will get their turn. And after that, we would go to end scoring. And we would have to play 10 rounds if we were three players. And after the ninth or tenth round, you would calculate your score. Each player will calculate how many points they have earned. So you will see how many glory points you have in this green area. This player has 52. And then you will calculate all the points on your cards. And this player has 20 plus 30, 50, 60, 66 plus 52. So 118 points. This player would have received 118 points. And the player with the most victory points is the winner of the game. If two or more players are tied, then they will share victory. To give you a better feeling of the game, I will now play a couple of rounds of the game. And the black player is the start player. They will both receive a divine blessing twice because this is the version for two players. If you're playing with three or more, then they will only roll their dice once. They both get one coin and two victory points, or one gold. And they can roll again and put the second roll up here. This player will receive two gold, and this player will receive one gold and one of the red. Now it's the active player's turn. And they haven't any cards, so step number two will not be performed now. And then we will go to the action phase. He can choose one of two actions. He only has gold, so he has to go to the temple and buy some new die faces. I actually like this one very much, where you can be able to get 6 gold coins. So he will spend 4 gold, and he has 2 left. And I think he will buy this blue one, so he can get some more of the moon, so he can be able to buy some of these cards. And I think he will make this die a strong money die. And this one will go on the other die. And then he would be able to take one more action if he had had 2 of these red, but he doesn't, so he can't take another action. Then it's the next player's turn. Both players will receive 2 times the white blessing, and he will get 1 red and 1 blue, and he will get 2 gold, and the second roll, and he will get 1 gold and 1 blue, and he will receive 2 gold. So this player, he has 7 money to spend, and I think he will buy this one where he will receive 1 victory point and 1 of the red, and then he will buy this one for free gold, where he can receive 4 gold. So he will spend all his 7 gold and upgrade his dice. So I think he will put this one on this one and this one here. And then this player, he can take one more action. I think he will. He will use these 2 red so he can take one more action. And he can buy 1 for 1 blue. And I think he will go over here and take this card, which will be worth 2 victory points. And he will immediately get one of these, so he has more room on his board. This card I will put face down. I will put it here then. And that was this player's turn. And both players has had their turn, so we will move this round marker. And it's the start player's turn again. And that was a look at how Dice Forge is played. And if you want to see more of the gameplay, then you can watch my playthrough where I will play this game to the end. And I will put a link up to that in this video. I really enjoy playing Dice Forge. It's a quick game. It's an easy game to teach. Also to players that haven't really played board games before. All that I have taught this game have enjoyed the game. And they really liked the game and wanted to play more of it after we have played the game. And Line, she also enjoys this game very much. I like the idea of these dice where you can manipulate them. And make them how you want them to be. And in this game, I have played with the standard cards for the game, but there are more cards, so you can swap some of them out, so that will give you more replayability with the game. And this game is pretty easy to learn. I think it's easy to teach people, they will grasp it pretty quick, and they really enjoy rolling these dice and making them how they want them to be. And then you also have all the cards and thinking a strategy out, so how you can kind of make the best path and get the most victory points. You can play it in a different way each time you play the game. It's not a deep, deep game. It's a light Euro game. So you have to like those lighter games, because this is what this is. But it's very family friendly and easy to learn. And still it's fun, and you get to roll dice when it's not your turn. You don't have to wait all the way until it's your turn to you can do something. In each turn, at the start of a player's turn, you may roll your dice and get some stats so you can think out what you want to do on your next turn. With all the money and all the reds and blues values you will get, so which cards do you want to buy? And I really enjoy this game, and all I have played with have enjoyed the game. And I really like how they have made the box also. They have made inserts for everything in this game. They have thought of it all. It's a good quality box, and the game components is quite good also. And yeah, that's only good things to say in that way about the game. So this game, Dice Forge, definitely gets thumbs up from me, and it also gets thumbs up from Line. Thanks for watching. Bye.